place for everything and everything in its place. Well, that's what data management is all about, isn't it? In the good old days, we used to manage just fine with filing cabinets. What fun this guy's having here. But no one would really want to go back to that. Someone took the file. Coffee stains all over the contents. Missing papers. Files put back in the wrong place. Then things moved on. Computers came to help us out. The power of the mighty spreadsheet. To solve all your data management worries. But they turned out to be not all that, didn't they, really? In reality, because you can't share them properly, information quickly becomes misinformation.
So spreadsheets are great. Filing cabinets are necessary. But you've all got spreadsheets. I've got them myself. They're amazingly powerful things, but there's an awful lot of problems with them as well. You can't attach photos or documents. People try and all use them at the same time and they get locked. People duplicate them, so somebody will take one piece of information, someone will take another piece of information, and it gets duplicated. There's lots of things they can do, but there's a lot of problems with them. So we've got Integrator for you. Integrator is a piece of software that brings all this data together and allows you to connect it together, to access the data when you want it, to get reports out in a format you want them, and when you want them, and how you want them. A short demonstration now, just to show you some of the things that Integrator can really do for your business.
Reporting is one of the most important aspects of a database. So let's have a look at what Integrator can do. If we go to the accidents module here, we can see a list of all the accidents that have happened within a particular business. If we select the injury classification column here, we can report very easily on the statistics of those different injury classifications. It's very simple to then produce those as a graph, and as we can see, you can output that in all sorts of different ways, a funky donut graph there. And you can view the statistics and the data in different ways, a sum or an average, and hovering over the bars gives you the numbers in that case. You can also export the data to various different forms. So if we want to send that directly to a Word document, then you can see that's what we've done here. There's the Word document and there's the graph placed in it straight away. So we go back to the menu and have a look quickly at the risk assessment module. So what kind of outputs do you get once you've finished inputting all your risk assessments? Well, there's a list of risk assessments. Just pick one of these. You can see the HSC five-step approach there. We have a number of tabs across the top which give a lot of detail about exactly what the risk assessment contains. It also has links in all these columns to different resources, to the employees, the locations, any equipment that might be used, and you can add documents and pictures and so on. So we're just going to have a look at something a little bit more detailed now to do with the reporting, which is in the employee module. So within employees, for a particular person, we can produce a number of different reports. Here you can see timesheets and various other reports you can get out. But if we're going to have a specific look at the exposure to vibration, there's a dedicated vibration module in this software. We can pick a start time and an end time for the reporting period, and then that's now going to produce the statistics from the database and bring up a report. So here's our report for the given time period for a particular employee, showing for each day what equipment that person has used, how long they've used it for, the reference of the equipment, what they were doing, and whether they've exceeded their daily vibration allowance according to the regulations. So very, very powerful to be able to produce that very quickly. Just going to go back to the accident module just to show you something specific about the way you handle information and data for a particular incident or accident. So we can, first of all, we've got the list there, so we can filter that down by RID or reportable, what part of the body was injured, and you can see there's various selections there. Go back to all on that one. We're just going to pick one of these and go into it and look at the detail of it. So here you can see we have a number of different ways of viewing different bits of data for that accident. And you can run through these as a procedure, and you can attach lots of information, documents there, photographs, and even video clips. If you have a CCTV footage, for example, you can attach the video here. I'm just going to play this one on the inbuilt browser. It should be interesting. You can see this this guy's driving this forklift truck through a space that is clearly too narrow. So we're able to attach this information to the accident reporting. There it goes. That racking certainly isn't going to have any future, I don't think.
Wow, that's a great clip, isn't it? I hope you enjoyed it. So we've just shown you a real small part of what Integrator could do for your business, for health and safety and HR. There's plenty more information on the website. There's plenty more videos we've got for you as well. If you want to find out any more, or if you'd like to come and talk to us or us to come and talk to you, just give us a call. There's a number coming up on the screen in a minute. Bye for now.